Okay, I have returned, and as of returning, I realized apparently we have an achievement that I don't remember getting. Wonders of the World. Reach the very top of the peak. Oh, so we did get an achievement for that. I guess I either just didn't notice or there was UI in the way right when it popped up. So that's an extra 5 primogems from climbing that thing that already gave us a shit ton of primogems. That is fucking awesome. Okay, now I'm assuming it's, where is it? It's out past that big shard thing, I'm pretty sure. But it says that there's, oh. Might as well grab it while it's here.
Yep.
Excuse me. Oh, it's that out there. I thought that was a challenge. There's a challenge right here above her head, but the fast travel point's out there on the nipple. Oh, there is a challenge out here. There's 2 challenges in one place. What the hell? These are specific to this area. Bam! Surveyor of Stone. Yes, baby. Five more primogems for unlocking all those. Okay, now let me check my progress on how much stuff we've collected down here. 63, so I should either get pretty close if I go over to that chili village, or I'll finish it. But there are a couple more items here on the beach, so I'm gonna grab those quick. The little star conks. Look who's here! What the hell? What the fuck is she doing here? She's pretty scary. Got her, yes. More grass, please. Give me your weed, man. Yeah, what the hell? All my momentum was lost and I just fell through the planet. We should definitely get it here. I'm pretty sure, because it just didn't feel like there was a lot here, but there should be. Because all these single flowers, they add up. And you get a 3er here.
Hey.
And 2 3s in a row, that makes a 6. Wait, where is this one here? It's telling me that there's an, oh, fucking dummy. Yes, more chilies. The thing is because I haven't claimed that Battle Pass weapon yet, it's still saying that I've got a notification up there, so I can't see exactly when I finish each one of these challenges. That's the wrong button altogether. 91, so we just need 9 more. Okay, good, 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 good. Good, 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 good. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Mission should be complete now. Yes, nice. That's level 36 in the battle pass, which will grant us a shitload of money. Oh, right. Now let's go north and let me collect some Mondstadt regional specifics and get that one out of the way. Oh, shit. That means Stormbearer is going to be a whole bunch tougher now, isn't he? I should have fought him before I did the world level upgrade. Fuckers. Let me actually check my characters here. I want to see if any of my characters have a Mondstadt specific region thing where it shows up on the minimap. Where is it? That would be in talents, right? Nope. Official? Nope. Nope. You don't have one. Nope. 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 Displays location of nearby ore? I thought it said penis. I thought that's what it said. She decreases swimming, I guess, because she's a captain. Okay, so none of my characters have a Mondstadt region specific thing, it looks like. Okay, that's fine. The dailies have reset. Yeah, it's 301 now. Well, there's another 90 primigems. Yep. Yeah. I came up here specifically because I knew that there was going to be stuff. Because I know that there's those berry bushes or whatever, tar berries, that give you a shitload of them per plant, 4 per plant. I'm pretty sure. In fact, right here is one of them. Oh, Valberry, not Tarberry. What am I thinking of? I know Tarberry something. Where am I getting that from? Tarberries. Who am I supposed to be killing here? You guys? No, these guys. Hold on, we've got a dandelion here, though. I had my white chocolate bunny today that I picked up from the Easter candy section on the way out. That was fucking delicious. I haven't had a chocolate bunny of any type in years, I'm pretty sure. Fun fact, this is going to be kind of nasty to some people. I'm too scared to look at it. But on my desk, right to my left, underneath all of my old books and stuff, just stacked up, there is a box that's inside of it. And it's opened, mind you, but it's closed up, if that makes sense. It was opened previously. Inside is an old white chocolate bunny, but it's from an off-brand, like a cheapy brand, you know, like a 90-cent chocolate bunny. So I didn't like it when I was eating it, but I was still able to eat it, and I didn't want to waste it, so I ended up hanging on to it for a while, and I just take a bite out of it every other day or something, because chocolate keeps for quite some time. Fun fact, but that is from 2014, and it's still here. no, I do not eat off of it anymore. I'm too scared to get it out from underneath all those books and see what's inside. But another fun fact is, once upon a time, I actually used to have a bag of Flamin' Hot Cheetos, one of the small bags, and I never ended up finishing them. There was only like 5 or 6 left in the little bag, and that stayed on my desk for, I think, 6 years straight. It stayed right on the right side of my desk because I never wanted to touch it because I didn't know it was inside the bag anymore. So I was too afraid to touch it. And I remember one time when I actually did end up going to throw them away finally, I was in a voice chat with a friend and we were like, well, I should just try to eat one. I didn't even, you know, because I didn't have the balls to do that, but simply picking it up, it was basically like Jell-O. Yes, the crunchy Cheetos that are known for their crunch were basically like picking up a piece of clay. It was the softest, droopiest, saddest little thing that I touched in my entire life. Yes, sadder than the size of my penis, and that's saying quite a bit. So that's just a fun fact. I have never, since those days, kept anything on my desk for that long because, well, I just don't want to. You know, I do have standards. Not many, but I do have them. Where are we at on this? We're only at 66? Jeez, I thought those Valberries were doing a lot of damage. Not as much as the chilies, it seems. There's another bush right there. Well, that's 70. Yeah, and I can't fight Storm Terror right now because I don't have the juice to do so. Checking down there to see if I can see anything off the sides of these. We do still have to explore some of our already explored regions to see if I can find what I haven't collected in those areas yet. Like the oculuses that are bothering me so much because there shouldn't even be that many left. Or there's actually quite a few left that I know I'm missing because we only need one more level for that thing. And that would be nice to get that. To fully upgrade that statue. Because, I mean, that's one of our achievements even. For the one of the remaining achievements for the Mondstadt region is to fully upgrade that statue, and if I only have to upgrade it one more time, or what I assume to be one more time, but we're still missing a healthy selection. I think it's like 15 it needs to upgrade, right? And we've only got like 5. So there's a lot of them missing. Where are they? I don't know. That's why I need to go back and search through each of the areas that isn't 100%, and we'll just comb it again and not find shit, because that's how combing works. I don't see any more Valberries over here. Like, we'll probably have to kill every enemy and inspect every little thing just to make sure that I'm actually getting what I need to get. When we're re-exploring regions, because as we've seen, killing enemies sometimes just opens up a random chest, so. Or makes a random chest appear. I came over here because I know that there's 3 dandelions. We've been through this routine a lot, haven't we? No, wait, I want the meat. And then I accidentally, while spamming all of the keys, I hit the wrong one and it threw me off the cliff. So in the end, I think we only grabbed... Oh, I saw some of the juice drop. Juice? Who's got the juice? You fucking little shits.
I missed! Yes!
Oh, I hate these guys so much. They can hit you from like a fucking mile away.
Yep.
And then sometimes they randomly die with a huge amount of health left, which I'm not complaining about. Wait. What the hell's down there? It's just the land. There's nothing of any importance down there. Pretty sure I went over there and checked that area. I remember it. You can sit on this rock. But why? I don't know. I may never know. What the hell is this? Oh, the commissions have started again, have they not? Yeah. Looks like they're all down here in this region, so fuck it.
Let's do them.
Get some more battle pass progress. Battle pass. Shit, he's up here. Because then while we're doing the commissions, maybe we'll come across something we need out in the world. Why is it replenishing itself? Or doing it again? Jeez. Now I gotta talk to him again. Yeah, I guess we needed to go get his food, but we've already got it. Yeah, I'm sure I've got plenty of those. Yay, everybody. Oh, we got some milk. He needs some milk. It's our first bit of milk. There's some of those pinwheel flowers up here. I didn't even think about that. So we can grab those. Well, they're called wind wheels, but they're basically pinwheels. Gonna be the one with the towers again? No, it's just a group of enemies this time.
A small step for villagers.
Hey. Yeah, yeah, come on, bring it. This is ridiculous. Oh god, I didn't even notice him for a second. That kind of scared me a little bit. Okay, but at least he has no shield anymore. I forgot I don't have Chi-Chi, so I'm not healing. Shit, we hit each other. And I know that we've done this one before. This is the Eye of the Storm one, I think. Actually, have we done both of these? No, this is the tower one right here, increasing danger, yeah. And this is the Eye of the Storm one? Yep, emergency. Okay. So we get to fight a bigger, higher leveled Eye of the Storm, which shouldn't be too bad. Too bad. Got a sketchbook that I hope I can start doodling in this weekend. I've got a few ideas. Level 56. Oh, he's still taking a lot of damage, though. Okay, and now for increasing danger. And then I think that's all of them, is it not? 1, 2, 3, 4, yep. And we've done our dailies for the day. Alright, again. Okay, I know there's some dandelion over here. Shoot, I still missed. Only one thing left to do. Gonna have to cut the whole wiener off. Everybody's gonna freeze now, yes. Well, me too, because there's a cryo guy. How did you throw that? You were frozen. What? How is that even fair? That's so stupid! Like, holy shit! He's fucking frozen and in the middle of a charge, so when he unfreezes, he turns as he's frozen and starts whacking me a whole bunch. Okay, he's dead. Okay, let's go turn it in and get our rewards from that. So we didn't really find many monster stuff while we were out there. Oh, what is this? It is telling me about notices. Update summary. Awesome. Don't care. That's that daily mission. So we got 84 of 100 monstat local specialties. Still got to do 5 bosses. I don't know what boss we defeated that counted as one. It says we've got 5 of 10. I wonder if it was actually the Eye of the Storm. That was the boss, wasn't it? Okay. So that's actually gotten us a little progress there without needing to worry about resin. Yeah, I'm definitely not doing the Storm Terror Domain Challenge until I have the resin. That's 60 for that, right? It's also worth 675 points, so we could get another battle pass level out of it. All right, let me look at this here. Let me see. Okay, never mind. I guess I gotta look at it here. Yeah, the black sword. So I don't know what weapon to choose. So it looks like they all have the exact same thing, where it's a crit rate increase. But let's see what the actual justice thing here is. So for this, it increases damage dealt by normal and charged attacks by 20%. Additionally, regenerates 60% of attack as HP when normal. What? Or 60% of attack as HP when normal and charged attacks score a crit hit. So it heals you. And then the serpent spine, which is the claymore. Every 4 seconds a character is on the field, they will deal 6% more damage and take 3% more damage. Okay, so they deal more and take more. This effect has a maximum of 5 stacks and will not be reset if the character leaves the field, but will be reduced by 1 when the character takes damage. So it's like a multiplier, basically. Okay, and then there's this thing here. Elemental burst damage. Then there's the bow. I don't really think we need the bow right now. Well, I guess we do have other bow characters now, though, don't we? Yeah, so attacks have a 50% chance to generate a cyclone, which will continuously attract surrounding opponents, dealing 40% of attack as damage to those opponents every 0.5 seconds for 4 seconds. And then the pole arm. If there are at least 2 opponents nearby, attack is increased by 16%, and defense is increased by 16%. If there are less than 2 opponents nearby, attack is increased by 24%. Yeah, see, I was going to do one of the swords, because we don't really have any awesome sword to give to someone, but I think I might even do the pole arm, because I do want to get Xiang Ling back up to snuff. The pole arm might be able to do that. But then again, like, I don't know. Like, let me go look at here, because I know that we have that prototype claymore. So let's see what this actually looks like over here stat-wise. Like, see some of these here, normal and charge attacks. ...50% chance to deal an additional 240% attack damage. Good lord. Like, what about the spikes? After picking up an elemental orb, normal and charged attacks deal a damage equal to 20% of attack. After using an elemental skill, increases normal and charged attack damage. Yeah, I still think that the pole arm is actually better in the event thing. Wait, where's... Oh no, these are the claymores here. Okay, I thought these were the normal swords. Those are down there. So let me see. So we have the prototype archaic, which is, on hit, normal or charged attacks have a 50% chance to deal an additional 240% attack damage to opponents within a small AoE. It can only occur once every 15 seconds. Versus on hit, normal or charged attacks increase attack and defense. So, yeah, I like this. So what we're going to do is I think we're going to get the pole arm. The deathmatch. Okay, now that I have finally equipped or gotten that, I don't have that little thing showing up anymore. Okay, and where is our stuff at right now? 14, so I can't do very much with that. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to close the game for a little bit. We're going to come back to it a little later because I need to get something to eat. And hopefully by the time we come back to it a little later, I'll have a little bit more of this that we can use and then we can do some of our other weeklies. Bye.